Hello there. Welcome to this lecture. In this lecture, we are going to implement simple linear regression, but this time we are going to use Python provided library. We are not going to write our own algorithm. We will use Python provided library and we will measure the score, the performance score for that model to make sure it is working. Let's begin. The first step, as you know, is defining what we are going to do. So let's write here the heading simple linear regression demo and heading. Yes, I know, but I'm still going to do that. And next, let's import libraries. Import numpy, np, import pandas as pd, and import seaborn as SNS, and last but not least, very important, import matplotlib.pyplot as plt. Very good. Now we should get our data set. Import data set, mark it markdown. The source of the data set you will find in the description of this lecture. Just download that data set somewhere on your computer and then you can run this command for the pandas data frame to read that file. It is going to be text file, pd dot, even though it is a text file, you will still say pd.cs_csv, say r, and put the path where you have stored the file. The file name is bldg_stories.txt. Delimiter you should put as / yes and plus and close it. That's it. And let's print df ahead to make sure it is there in data hub and let's run it. Very good. So data is there. It is basically the data of building heights versus stories. These are the years, and this is just a collection of data, and this is the data set they have created for various years. Let's see how many observations are there. df.shape 60. So there are 60 observations they have right from 1990s to several other years. They have actually chronologized height of the buildings versus stories. What is the first thing you check in data exploration? Checking shape also is part of data exploration. So we have already begun data exploring. Data exploration. Okay, so now we are in the data exploration step. I already checked the shape and I know there are 60 observations. Next, we're going to check if there are any null values, and command for that is df is null and sum. Awesome. There are no null values. The height and stories, the data we are going to play around, are already numeric data. So we do not have to encode it. So that is one step we don't have to do. Next, we're going to see what kind of distribution it has. It should have normal distribution for us to use linear regression algorithm. And command for that is, you already know, SNS, that is seaborn dist plot and HT and then plt.show. Very good. Here you go. It looks very much normal distributions. There are some anomalies here, but we can ignore it for now. So overall, it looks a normal distribution. Good news. Now that we know it's a normal distribution, we are going to check the kind of relation between height and stories. First step in that is to draw a scatter plot. Very good. Let's say plt.show. And here you go. The scattered relationship. It looks like a normal, simple linear regression. The height increases along with the stories. So we can play around and use simple linear regression. Okay, I think we have enough information about data now. We can move on to next phase, that is data preprocessing. Data preprocessing, make it mark down. As part of data preprocessing, we are first going to separate the data frame data in X and Y. We are going to predict the number of floors, that number of stories the building can have based on its height. So the X variable is going to be height, and then Y is going to be number of floors. So far so good. You got the X and Y. Before we move on and before we split this X and Y further into train and test dataset, we have to convert them in NP array. At this point, they are in pandas data frame. For you to be able to use sklearn simple linear regression algorithm, you need to convert them to NP array. And it is very easy. Just to close this here and then say values. Likewise, do the same thing for the other one. Close it and say values. So far so good. And next we're going to split the data set in train and test data set. Split data in train and test data set from sklearn dot model selection import train test split. And now X train, X test, Y train, Y test is going to be train test split, X and Y test size is going to be 0.2 and random state is going to be 0. And let's print it. X train, X test, Y train, Y test, and let's run it. Very good. So we got the data here. Looks good. So instead of printing everything, we could have just print the size. Shape, maybe let's say shape dot shape dot shape and dot shape. Yeah, 48 12 48 12. Awesome. So far so good. Next we're going to do model selection. Data preprocessing is done. It is time to select the model, and this is where the critical part of selecting correct algorithm starts. Based on what we have seen so far, it's a simple distribution and there is a linear regression relationship between the height and stories. If one increases, the value of other also increases. So it's a simple linear relationship. So we're going to use a simple linear regression model. And the simple linear regression model is going to come from sklearn. From sklearn dot linear model import linear regression. Here let's say linear reg equals linear regression. Okay, so now next thing is to train the model. Train model. Why do we need to train the model? Any idea? Think about it. It is something related to calculating the coefficients and y-intercept. Why do we need to provide training data sets to this model? Think about it. Yes, you got it. The algorithm is there, but every simple linear regression has its own coefficients, its own y-intercept and its own b1, the b0 b1 we were talking about, right? And that b0 b1 can be calculated only based on the data. That is why you provide training data set to that model so that it can calculate the coefficients for your data. We're going to print those coefficients. Let's do that. Print coefficients. Print y intercept. And the command for that is linear dot intercept. And then next one is print coefficient, let's say coefficient b1, and you can get that by saying linear reg dot coef underscore. Let's see, here we got the values. The y-intercept in this case is -2.5 and the coefficient is 0.078. So your model is ready. The Python library has trained itself with your data and it has returned the coefficient and intercept. That means it has got this equation here. Y equals -2.55635 plus 0.0784x. So that's the equation it has derived for your data. Next, we are going to test these coefficients, these linear models, this equation by providing the test dataset. That's why we split. The train data set was to train the model so that it can calculate the coefficients, and test data set is to test it whether that coefficient, that y-intercept which it calculated, is giving you the correct values. Let's do that. We are going to predict y values. Y pred equals linear reg dot predict and x test. We got this equation. Now we are providing x data here and it is going to give us the y, and that y we will call as a y predict. Let's draw and then we will be able to compare. Let's say plt dot scatter give us the scatter, and next we're going to plot the regression line with x test and y pred value, and so this. Let's run it. Awesome, here you go. Let's say color equals red. Now we got this y predicted values. This red line is based on y predicted values and it looks very much okay, right? It is going in between the scattered dots. It looks like that it is able to predict the behavior. No problem. If it's not very clear with the graph, we're going to compare the values. Let's compare the y predicted values with the y test values and then we will know. Okay, so let's say df1 is going to be pd dot data frame. We're going to have actual values, which is y test, and that we're going to compare with the predicted value. Predicted is going to be y underscore predicted here, pred. And now let's print this df1.head. And let's compare 72, 69, not that great, but 31, 32, 21, 30, 54, 55. It's pretty close. The predicted values are pretty close with the actual values. You know what? Let's do a bar chart. That will give it a more clarity. So let's say df2 equal to df1.head, have 15 rows, and let's plot it. df2.plot kind is bar, and then let's say figure size is 16:10, and next just put the major and minor guidelines. Let's do the same thing for the minor lines. For minor lines, just say minor here. And let us show it. Here you go. Now you can compare. It's very clean, right? Now you can see the actual value. The blue ones are actual values and orange ones are the predicted values. Yeah, pretty good. So looks like our model is working. It is able to predict the stories of the building based on its height. But this is only the 15 data points we are comparing. How can we be sure that the whole model for the 60 records, 60 observations is very effective and it is going to predict properly for future data? Like, so how can we be sure that the data model we have created, the coefficients and the y-intercept we came up with and this equation we came up with actually is working fine for the whole data set of 60 observations? So to do that, there's something called metrics. You can always calculate the performance of your model. For metrics, you are going to import the metric method. So from sklearn, you are going to import metrics from sklearn. The model performance I was talking about is called R2 score. It's also called model score. We're going to use R2 score from sklearn metrics. So sklearn dot import R2 underscore score. we are going to measure few things: mean absolute error, mean squared error, and the R2 score. Let's print the R2 score first. Let's print R2 score, and the command for that is R2 underscore score, and then over here you put the Y test value and then Y predicted value. Very good. Let's print this. The R2 score is 84%. Not bad. It's not excellent. You can always improve this, but 84% is a decent score, and it also depends on the kind of data. If you talk to data scientists, there are split opinion on this. Some of the data scientists believe that when it comes to linear regression model, it's not only R2 score which actually shows the performance of your model. You have to also look at the mean squared error and root mean squared error. So let's calculate that. And the way to calculate that is you just going to call this matrix.mean absolute error and provide the value, same value, y test and y pred. Mean absolute error is 4.1. Okay. Next, we're going to print the mean squared error. And once again, it's going to be matrix.mean squared error, y test and y pred. Mean squared error is 31, and next one is root mean squared error, np dot square root of mean squared error. So these are the metrics by which you can say whether your model performance is good or not. These are all statistical terms, and I will put a lecture or put a detailed block explaining each one of them. Oh, before we move on, let's not forget to save the notebook with the proper name. By the way, you can find each of these notebooks, whatever I'm writing here, all these Jupyter notebooks are there on my GitHub. I will also put a link to the GitHub on the description of some of the lectures. Very good. I will see you in next lecture.